since we are running out of time, I'm only going to give you, because CNV is an important topic, I'm giving you three key messages from three slides. We all know that exudative age-related macular degeneration could be either extrafoveal or subfoveal or juxtafoveal. Those which are extrafoveal can be managed easily by thermal laser. Even today, that's the best choice. For juxtafoveal and subfoveal CNV, the gold standard is still ranibizumab. Aflibercept is useful for non-responders, especially occult CNV with PEDs. All these patients which are active get three loading doses, which are given on a monthly basis in all cases of CNV. After you've given the first three doses, assess the response at month three. If your lesion is now dry, these patients need to be followed up on a PRN basis and treated on a PRN basis with monthly follow-up. If there is no recurrence for the next 3 months after this, you can now do what is known as a monitor and extend approach. That means you increase the period of follow-up from 4 to 6 weeks, 8 weeks, and then to 12 weeks. But if the patient gets recurrence, you treat him and then on a PRN basis and then follow up monthly. The second group of patients are those where the lesion becomes stable but does not become dry. These are the patients where one choice is to you keep on giving monthly. If over the next 3 months they dry, great. But supposing they do not dry, you have two choices. One, you can give a trial of aflibercept to see whether these patients respond. And the second group is those where you can try a treat and extend regime till you reach quarterly injections of Lucentis. The last group of patients is those in which, despite your treatment for the first 3 months, the vision is still decreasing and the lesion is active. Here you choose either aflibercept or you continue with your monthly injections if you can get the patient to become stable. In patients who are not responding or who become stable and yet have not reached good visual acuity, you could consider using aflibercept. And very often, like you see in this patient, which patient had received almost 12 injections, but one injection follow of aflibercept, it started drying. After the resolution of this, we put the patient back on Lucentis again. This is another patient where, again, a similar thing happened. The vision deteriorated from 6.9 to 18 despite getting regular injections, was given an injection of aflibercept, improved, and then shifted back to maintenance with Lucentis. So this is, of course, before you do this, you must rule out PCV because polypoidal choroidal vasculopathy is managed better with either photodynamic therapy with Lucentis. This can make the treatment more finite. Or if the patient says, I don't want PDT, then the option is aflibercept monotherapy. Ladies and gentlemen, there are only three, there are some conditions where you don't need to treat. A condition like eye that looks like this does not need treatment. An eye which has reached a scar and this hemorrhages, if they are old, do not need treatment. But most importantly, a patient with 6-6 vision, even with this kind of lesion, if it is not progressive, does not need treatment because occult CNV is only treated when it is progressive. I think this is the, basically, with this kind of approach to treatment, you can expect to keep your patients happy for a long time. You can expect that three-line vision loss will be limited to 1/3 of your patients, but 1/4 of your patients will have excellent vision of better than 6/12. So this is why even now it's very important you continue the patients on treatment as and when required with high index of suspicion for treatment. The moment there is any vision loss, the moment there is no new fluid, the moment there is any new hemorrhage, please treat your patients. Eternal vigil is the price we pay for maintaining vision in patients with CNV. Thank you very much.